This is a quick video teaching you how to create a pie chart in Adobe Illustrator. Now, I happen to be working in Illustrator 5.0. You may be in 5.5 or perhaps an earlier version. Don't worry, the principles are the same. Begin by creating a new file. I'm going to name this one Pie Chart 1. And notice I come up with a new document. I look over my toolbar, and as I look down my toolbar, I find a bar graph. Double-click the bar graph, and it opens up a new window with a series of different graph types. I happen to want the pie chart. I choose it, tell it OK. Notice my cursor changes from the arrowhead to the crosshairs. This will outline the box for my pie chart. Now I want to constrain this to a perfect square, so I'll hold down my shift key and draw out a box. Notice I now have a pie chart with one piece of data in it. Next to it is another chart in which I will actually enter the data itself. I'm going to make up some quick numbers here by typing in. Notice each time I finish typing, I will click on the box next to it. That way I know I've entered the data. And one more. I now have four individual data points. Simply click the checkbox and I have a basic pie chart. Now, chances are you don't want your pie chart to be black and white, so you would want to add a color. Notice my swatch palette over here happens to be all RGB colors, and I want a Pantone color, a PMS color. Now, let's say, for instance, your Pantone colors aren't open. I happen to know that in 5.0, I can open my swatch library by hitting the drop-down arrow, going up to my color books, which is where these happen to be stored. I go down to Pantone, solid coded, and it opens up my library of Pantone colors in solid coded. Now here's the variety of different colors. Chances are one of yours is in there. I'm going to choose this one, which is 129, add it to my swatch library. And just so I don't make a mistake here, I'm going to pull in one, drag over the color here. And I now have selected this section to be in PMS 129. Just so I don't make a mistake and inadvertently grab an RGB color, I want to get rid of everything I don't need. I'll hit my drop-down arrow, select all my unused colors, hit my trash can, which deletes the swatches. Yes, I'd like to get rid of them. And for some reason, I'm hanging on to a couple of other colors I don't want. I'll get rid of those as well. There's a duplicate black that I don't need, and there's this orange. So now I have only the colors black, white, and PMS 129. I'll drag my PMS 129 in. I'm going to drag my black in. Now, you may not be able to do this in earlier versions. You may have to select your selection tool up here and click on a section and then click on a color. But the principles, again, are basically the same. This is a little coarse, all black and bright gold. I want to tone that down a little bit. And the way I'll do that is I will choose the hollow arrow up here. Click off, click a section. Notice my tints have changed. This could be slightly different again in the version you use, but I can use my slider bar, change this to 40%. I could also click on a section. Instead of using the slider bar, I'll actually type in my number, 20%. And I think I'd like to tone down that yellow, say bring that down to 70%. And notice I have a simple pie chart. It happens to be bordered in black. It's all ready to go. If I happen to say I need to exaggerate or want to exaggerate that a little more, I can choose my chart and increase my stroke. Darkens up that a little bit. And now simply save it. And that means I can go back. Now, having saved it as an Adobe Illustrator file, I can go back and work with it anytime I need to. Say the superintendent says, oh, you made a mistake and we need to change some of the data. I can go back and choose one of the areas, change the data. Once I have it where I'm sure I want it, I tend to save it now as, I need to click off the boxes. I'm going to do a file save as an Adobe EPS. Illustrator EPS rather, and that will enable me to import it directly into my Adobe InDesign file. And there you have a very simple pie chart in Adobe Illustrator.